the Lord loved us so much that in our poverty, in our hell, I would come and deliver the broken, destroyed, messed up, poor, impoverished people I'm going to save.
Hey, Shalom Israel, Yahweh Bashimel Shadrach a Thug, Yahweh Shema'al a Thug, Bashimel Shadrach all the sisters, man. Listen, it's Captain 13,000, the Card of a Rhyme, checking in with the Israelite School of UPK, under Commander Jerry Hunt. Listen, man, this year's 52nd annual Passover. Hold on, I'm gonna say it one more time. This year's 52nd annual Passover under Commander Jerry Hunter under the ISUPK. Couldn't do it last year. Y'all already know the Lord had his foot on our oppressor's neck.
Here in New York City, there are roughly 1,000 cases a day. Those are numbers they haven't seen since May.
Can't do it in New York this year because the Lord still got his foot on our oppressor's neck.
New York, the center of the outbreak this spring, is now teetering on another deadly explosion of the virus.
But listen to me good. This year, 52nd annual Passover, April 24th, 2021. You understand? It's going to be in H-Town, baby.
It's going to be at the B&H Ranch, 14149 Player Street, Houston, Texas.
Y'all know what we do. Y'all know what we came to do. Huh? 2021, ISUPK, 52nd annual Passover. All the generals gonna be there. All the heavy hitters gonna be there. The daughters of Zion gonna step out with their beautiful long dresses, you understand? Strong on deck. That One West style music on deck. 52nd annual Passover.
B&H Ranch, 14149 Player Street, Houston, Texas.
Get with it to get lost, man.
Got it out the mud, straight up out the base. The world done made me crazy. The world done turned crazy.
You dealing with the men of war. We at war. I sided with the Lord, of course. On one accord. We ain't never stopping now. You running now. All my niggas go to ground. We go.
Black people have never done anything like that in America. Black people have never thought to go and storm an institution of democracy in this place. You know why? Because I'm gonna show you something. Black people are the real patriots of America. Hispanics and Native Americans are the true patriots of America. What we found out, our people found out 2 weeks ago, what these brothers back here have always known, is that the oppressor doesn't give a damn about America. He doesn't give a damn about his institutions of democracy and the sacredness of freedom and the beacon of hope on that shining hill. All that is garbage so they can sound good while they oppress God's children, because they hate America. These terrorists absolutely hate America.
Right.
While America goes across seas and patrols the world and fights to put democracy in these different nations, America can't even control their own backyard. They can't even control what's happening in their own house. And guess what? What America does not understand is that this is the hand of God at work. This is the beginning of the destruction of America. America is falling to her knees. You know why? Because if you have two different groups that are against each other in the same house, that house is going to fall. It's in the Bible. The Bible talks about it. Give me Mark 3 and 24. I'm going to show you. This is how you know America is going to fall. It's falling right now. Look around you. They have everything boarded up. They have military checkpoints in Washington, D.C., in the United States of America. And you know what's so beautiful? They're not looking for some guy in the turban. They're not looking for some guy with a suicide vest on, some Arab. They're not looking for black people, right now at least. Guess who they're looking for? Your so-called white nationalist organizations. Your Republicans, your good old boys, however you want to call them. Because guess what the FBI has to now acknowledge? That their own people are the terrorists. They've always known it. But the world wants to hide the fact of who these people's nature really is. And guess what? They got to acknowledge the fact that now that your people are the terrorists on the earth. Right. Duck Dynasty is the number one suspect, man. Swamp people. Yee, yee, yee. Shoot them. Those are number one suspects, man. While America has been oppressing blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans as if we are the terrorists, you letting the terrorists live in your same home. You sleeping with the terrorists. Well, guess what? Because America is divided against itself, this is how we know this place is falling and is going to continue to fall. God says so, man. The Bible has prophesied the destruction of America. The Bible has prophesied America falling to her knees. And it's right here. Read that. Mark chapter 3, verse 24. And if a kingdom be divided against itself, and if a kingdom be divided against itself, what is a kingdom according to the Bible? A kingdom is a country, man. And the Bible is saying if a country, a nation is divided against itself, what happens? Well, this is what the Bible says. This is what God says when your nation, your country is divided against itself. And if you couldn't tell, America is divided against itself. From the beginning of America, it was divided against itself. America has two major political parties that are against each other. That's how you know this empire started to fall. Like the beginning of America was the beginning of the end. And that's what we don't realize as blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans. While we go and serve this place as the real true patriots in our ignorance, we don't understand that the time for America is coming to an end. The time for this place to thrive off of our oppression and our destruction is coming to an end, man. Black man, you keep holding on, man. You hold on and get back here with these brothers back here, because you're going to sit back and watch how America implodes on itself. America is going to fall, and the Bible says so. Read that from the top. And if a kingdom be divided against itself, Democrats and Republicans, against itself, conservatives and liberals, against itself, Proud Boys and Antifa, against itself, Donald Trump and Joe Biden, against itself. This is what the Bible says about America. America is divided at the seams. And it didn't start with Donald Trump either. This has been going on since the beginning of America, man. America was established because they divided against Britain. They were supposed to be one nation with Britain. But they divided against Britain. And you know the thing about traitors? You start a group or organization or a land with traitors, that's what's going to happen. The same thing you did to that group is going to happen to your group. And America committed treason against Britain to establish this place. And guess what's going to happen? This place is going to fall the same way it started. Read. That kingdom cannot stand. That kingdom cannot what? Stand. America cannot what? Stand. Guess what? America is falling. America cannot stand. Somebody give America a crutch to stand on, because this whore cannot stand any longer, man. Because God is bringing her to her knees because of her treatment of his children, blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans. You think what's going on right now is just coincidence? The Lord is the author of this, man. The Lord is behind this, and God wants it. God absolutely wants to see this place fall. And we're going to see more and more terrorist attacks, more and more insurrection, more and more sedition, man. Do you know that is an actual crime in the law books in America? Sedition. Guess what? Before it was a crime in America's law books, it's in the Bible. It's prophesied in the Bible. Give me 2nd Esdras. Any more on that? Give me 2nd Esdras, chapter 15, verse 14. I'm going to show you how this Bible is powerful, man. In America, there's a law called sedition. Sedition is to inspire rebellion, to go against the authority or the government. And that's what we've seen when those terrorists, those oppressors stormed the Capitol. like barbarians, man. America's supposed to be the beacon of hope to the world. Democracy. Everybody's supposed to look to America on how they're supposed to run their nation. And that's what they had to look to? Huh? I'll let you know something. America, the world sees your shame and hypocrisy.
That's right.
As you go out through the earth and want to police the world and want to destroy the Lord's children, blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans, your people are the ones who should have always been profiled, should have always been scrutinized, should have always been followed and tailed. You know why? Because they're showing you who they've always been. The devil on the earth, man.
Right.
Black people were upset and outraged and astonished that these people can do such a thing to the Capitol Hill. Such a sacred place. Not Capitol Hill. Well, guess what? We found out just how much they don't give a damn about their country, about their laws, about their leaders. Because that's sedition. And guess what? Donald Trump inspired that rebellion against America. He inspired that, and the Bible talks about sedition right here. Y'all gonna find out today, this book is real. This book is absolutely alive, and it's real, and it talks about what's happening right now in this place. Second Esdras, you got that? Read that, chapter 15, verse 14. That's no sweat. The Bible talks about what's happening in America right now. And if we are black, Hispanic, and Native American, and you hear the sound of my voice, it will behoove you to listen to these prophets back here. Because before anybody else knew this was going to happen, we knew it was going to happen. Because the Bible said it was going to happen. Read 2nd Esdras, chapter 15, verse 14. Woe to the world. Woe to the world. You know what the word woe means? It's Old English for destruction. And the Bible is saying destruction to the world, man. Read. Woe to the world and them that dwell therein. Woe to the world. Destruction to the world and those that dwell therein. Read. For the sword and their destruction draweth nigh. Now, for the sword and their destruction draweth nigh, man. If you couldn't tell by that attack on Capitol Hill, the destruction of America draweth near, man. It's coming. Right now, the FBI is getting all types of reports and threats about attacks on every 50 states' Capitol building. That's how bad this is. It's coming. The sword is coming, man. You understand? Like, America's destruction is near, and the Bible prophesied it. You know how you know? I'll get you some more. Read. And their destruction draweth nigh. And one people shall stand up to fight against another. Whoa, 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 hold on. That sounds like what we just read. A kingdom divided against another. Read that again.
Okay.
And one people, read, shall stand up to fight against another. Democrats versus Republicans, man. Conservatives versus the liberals. Antifa versus the Proud Boys. Black people versus white people. And what you'll find out, that attack on Capitol Hill was these oppressors' attempt to remain in power over the Lord's children by violence, man. The same way they've always done. They got our people through violence. They stole us from our families and our mothers and fathers. And they murdered our grandmothers. And they brought us here to America. And they oppressed the Native Americans and the Hispanics and the black people here. And guess what? They are still committing acts of violence to maintain their control over God's children. That's what's going on right now. And what you're seeing is the oppressor is so hell-bent on controlling God's children that he's willing to come up against his own people. He's willing to rise up against his very own brother in arms. At the Capitol, they had off-duty police officers beating up fellow police officers. What happened to Black the Blue? What happened to Blue Lives Matter? You know what that really means? Blue Lives Matter means nothing to these oppressors. They only said Blue Lives Matter because they supported how the police murdered and abused Blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans. But when it was time to really show their solidarity and support and love for the so-called blue lives, that went out the window. Brian D. Sidnick died at the Capitol. Yeah, I know his name. Y'all murdered your brother at the Capitol. Brian D. Sidnick, Capitol Police Officer Brian D. Sidnick was murdered at the Capitol, man. You guys murdered your own brother. Not by us. Black people didn't do it. The Arabs didn't do it. Bin Laden didn't do it. Kim Jong-un didn't do it. You know who did it? Brian D. Sicknick's own brothers. His fellow white brothers, man. Baseball loving, American pie eating brothers. That's who killed that Capitol Police officer. This lets you know, this is how far these people are willing to go. They are the terrorists on the earth. And God is pleased with it. And more is coming. You know why? Because God wants to see the destruction of America. Right. America cannot live this way any longer. Because America was built on our destruction. So now God is going to laugh at their destruction. Read. And swords in their hands. Read that. Couple lines up. Woe to the world and them that dwell therein. For the sword and their destruction. Draw nigh. The destruction of America draweth nigh. Nigh is Old English for near. The destruction of America is near. Black man, Hispanic man, Native American Indian man. The destruction of this place, this great kingdom, is near. And you want to know when an empire is going to fall? Let's take the Bible out the equation. Look at the history of the Greeks and the Romans and Babylon and Egypt. Every nation came to its knees and destroyed when they were against each other. Civil wars is what brought these nations to their knees. Rome was destroyed because they were spread out so thin fighting everybody else. And within Rome, there was insurrection. There were Romans against Romans. They killed Julius Caesar in the Senate.
That's right.
We shouldn't be surprised at these oppressors' violence. They was trying to kill Mike Pence and take hostages. These terrorists came into the Capitol building with zip ties. Can you imagine if a black man came into the Capitol building, if he even made it past, because they would have shot one of us the moment we stepped foot on the stairs. Right. The same way they killed Miriam Casey, Carey, the water, sir. The same way they killed that sister, Miriam Carey, for making a U-turn at the Capitol. She made a U-turn, and they fired rounds and rounds into her car with her baby in the back. And then in Congress, they applauded the Capitol police officers for their so-called heroism. Right. Well, we was all them heroes when it was needed. When the Capitol was being attacked. Right. Where was all the heroes at? Right. These people are cowards, man. They're cowards, and the Lord is bringing their destruction near. This is how you know, read. And one people shall fight up against another. You watching right now, good old Americans is fighting fellow good old Americans, man. That's what you're watching. Of course, one side is gonna say they're the real patriots. Both sides are saying they're the patriots. The Democrats are saying they love America and they're the patriots. The Republicans are saying they love America and they're the patriots. And they're both fighting each other, man. This is how you know the destruction of America is right around the corner. I'm talking I Street right around the corner. It's coming. It's coming and God wants it. Read. To fight up against another and swords in their hands. And swords in their hands. Do you know when they came to that Capitol building and attacked it and laid siege on the Capitol Hill? They came with weapons. They came with masks. They came with two-hand radios. This was not your average riot that you see. This was a tactical military operation. And it was not the First Amendment rights. Right. What you're looking at right now is your First Amendment rights. This is what it looks like to follow the laws in America. This is it right here. These are law-abiding citizens right here. This is how you do it. What you seen at the Capitol Hill was terrorism.
That's right.
This is what America sent troops to go and fight and die for.
Right.
Terrorism by the only terrorist, man. the only terrorist that has always been in this place. And you've seen it. I ain't got to tell you who it is. It wasn't us out there. Black people was getting mad because we said if it was us, the response would have been much different. We weren't out there destroying America and destroying the Capitol. And this is what's happening. Read. For there shall be sedition. For there shall be what? Sedition. Sedition, man. If you go and look on the books right now, there is a felony law where sedition can get you time in prison, man. You understand? Sedition is to inspire rebellion or insurrection against the government or authorities. And that's what Donald Trump did. Donald Trump inspired his supporters to go and lay hold on the Capitol building, man. To go and absolutely attack. We gotta stop being friendly and politically correct in what we calling it, man. Those people at the Capitol weren't protesters, man. What this is right here is a protest, a righteous protest, a lawful protest. What they did at the Capitol was terrorism. An insurgency. They killing millions of Iraqis and Afghanistan people out over in the Middle East right now for being insurgents. Meanwhile, the real insurgents are right here. Homebred. Baseball and apple pie. The Lord is showing America has always been a nation of hypocrites. The Lord is bringing America's shame to light. And it's a beautiful thing, man. Because America portrays itself as a nation that is great, as a nation that is right and holy and just and unified at the water, the United States of America. Right, from today, it's the divided states of America, man. America going back to the snake, to the 13 colonies. You see that flag, what they had? You see a lot of them terrorists had that flag at the Capitol. And it's a yellow flag and it has a snake. And it's chopped into pieces. And it says, don't tread on me. America's going back to that. Different parts of the snake. You know what's beautiful about that? It's all a snake. It's just different parts. No matter what side it is, who's fighting, it's all part of the snake. And as Blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans, we should understand there's no side that we should join in these oppressors' fight. There's no side we should join, whether it be the Democrats or Republicans. Donald Trump or Joe Biden, there's no side for us, black man, Hispanic man, Native American, Indian man. We ain't got no horse in this race, man. Let them fight it out because God wants them to do this. Because the more America falls, the more we rise up. Keep reading. For there shall be sedition among men and invading one another. And what? Invading one another. Brother, this Bible is real. What we seen at Capitol Hill was an invasion. And one right here in America, you had one set of people invading another set. And they invading today. And all the capitals across America, they are making plans to storm and invade the capitals. How is it that you are supposed to be all red-blooded Americans, but you're going against your own people? Because the Bible said you would. The Lord has put that spirit in you to be the devil on the earth. And you revealing to the world like we have always known to be the devil. And it has to happen because our people need to see this is what we submit to. This is who we serve in love. And nobody's going to tell the truth. Nobody's been telling the truth that the real terrorists on the face of the earth is not Blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans. The problem in America has never been Blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans. You know, you found out when you seen that Capitol Police officer, that brother, and you seen all the black faces in the Capitol Police Department and the security guards, you know what you found out? That black people actually love America. Black people love this place so much. And black people have fought and died for this place. Black people have loved America. And what has America done? Return our love with hatred. Return our love with absolute hatred. When the oppressor has always been the biggest terrorist in America, man. They've always been a terrorist. And guess what? Now it's time for you Uncle Toms and you Aunt Jemimas to wake up and see it.
Right.
The Lord is making it more and more visible to those of you that want to keep your eyes closed and stay asleep in America. We fight for the American dream when our lives are nightmares in this place. Well, God is making you wake up now.
Right.
God is making you wake up and see just who is the villain. Just who is the terrorist. Give me 2 Thessalonians 3:2. I'll show you in here. The Bible talks about that, man. The Lord wants us to see who's the devil, man. Who is the problem? And if you couldn't tell by now, in 400 years of slavery, rape, oppression, gentrification, lies, scandals, crack in our neighborhoods, black women being kidnapped and destroyed, our children being lied to in these schools, if you couldn't tell by now who is the devil on the face of the earth, well, guess what? The Lord is making it absolutely crystal clear just who's the terrorist, just who these people are. You got that? 2 Thessalonians 2:3.
2 Thessalonians 2:3. Let no man deceive you.
The Bible is saying, let no man deceive you. Don't let nobody lie to you, man. Don't let nobody game you up, black man, Hispanic man, Native American, Indian man. You know how they do it? It's called propaganda.
Right.
And do you know through America's propaganda, we have believed that we are the problem, that we are nothing more than thugs and criminals, that we are the ones who should change and be more American so that we can make this place work better. When guess what? We've been deceived into believing that. The Bible says, let no man deceive you. The oppressor has deceived us with his propaganda, with his movies, with his media, with his lies. And he deceived us into believing that he is holy, that he is the one who's keeping us safe. He's the one that we can trust. He's the one that we can put our love and honor to. When guess what? We found out with the Capitol Hill attack, these people are not worthy to protect us. These people can't even protect their own people. They can't even protect their own government. Look at DC. They trying to protect this city, but it's after the fact. It's after the fact. Y'all let the Capitol get attacked by terrorists. And you know what's so hip, what's so funny? They put in 25,000 National Guard troops in DC. Y'all see it, right? Walking up down the street. They got military checkpoints, and you know what's so funny? They doing that to try to protect DC when the terrorists are in the uniforms.
Right.
Y'all brought the terrorists in the uniforms. There's white supremacists in every level of government in America, from Donald Trump all the way down. This is the problem with our people. We think Donald Trump is the beginning of racism and white supremacy, when white supremacy and racism was here before Donald Trump. And white supremacy and racism will be here after Trump.
That's right.
What you're gonna find out is Joe Biden is not gonna be any better for our people.
If you love the ISUPK, stay in the loop. Go to Google Play and download the new user-friendly One West ISUPK app and get exclusive footage to our online classes and street speaking videos. Also, the Black Watch podcast, hosted by Commanding General Yohanna, the leader of the Nation of Israel. It's real easy to stay in tune with the ISUPK and the information we're putting out. Just go to Google Play and type in One West UPK app and hit download. Let's get it in. Don't be left out.